SpaceX's Raptor engine completely outclassed Blue Origin's BE-4 engine. As you may know, SpaceX and Blue Origin are two companies that have been competing for several spacecraft and commercial contracts. We've even discussed their rivalry before, but today's focus is on the engines that power the huge rockets that both companies are creating, the Raptor and the BE-4. Since its launch in 2002, SpaceX has produced a large number of rocket engines. SpaceX completed its 100 Raptor engine a few months ago. This incredible milestone was accomplished in just 29 months, a little over 2 years. The BE-4 was first developed by Blue Origin Rocket Engine Facility in 2011. They stated that the BE-4 would be ready for flight by 2017. But as we speak, 4 years later, Blue Origin is pretty far behind schedule with its powerful BE-4 engine. The new engine's first flight test on the Vulcan rocket is now scheduled for 2022 due to BE-4's low reliability. This is a major issue that needs to be discussed. So how did Blue Origin's BE-4 engine become a joke? And how did SpaceX's Raptor, on the other hand, become the industry's premier example? We'll find out in today's video. But first, make sure you like and subscribe to this channel. It would be muchly appreciated. And without further ado, let's get into it. First, how has BE-4 survived over a decade of failure? This was the first engine to use liquefied natural gas and liquefied natural gas propellants. The Blue Origin-owned launch vehicle New Glenn, the company's first orbital rocket, was scheduled to employ the first engine. Vulcan Centaur, the United Launch Alliance's launch vehicle, was set to take over from the Atlas V vehicle, was supposed to use the same engine, according to the reports from 2014. The company aimed to begin full-scale engine testing by 2016 and complete the project by 2017. However, it was not until March 2017 that the first engine was built. Also, the United Launch Alliance, ULA, reported in March that the economic risk associated with using Blue Origin engines has been reduced. However, technical worries remained until the engine's first test flight were finished later in 2017. The loss of the power pack engine hardware of the BE-4 was reported by Blue Origin in May 2017 when a test anomaly occurred. The Blue Origin BE-4 rocket engine's powerhead and combustion chamber were the first to be hot tested. The test took place in October 2017. Finally, in July 2020, United Launch Alliance received the first Pathfinder BE-4 for integration testing with the Vulcan Centaur. At the end of 2020, through the CEO Tory Bruno, ULA stated that the second BE-4 test would be delivered shortly and followed by those who qualified in the first test. He did, however, mention a problem with the BE-4 turbopumps. According to Bruno, Blue Origin was still working to fix faults with the 75,000 horsepower pumps that carry fuel to the BE-4's primary combustion chamber at the time. But Bruno expressed confidence about the situation. In October, Bruno declared that the issue had been resolved and the engine was now in production. Surprisingly, it wasn't. In August this year, it became clear that the BE-4 engine program was still in jeopardy, which was frustrating. For 4 years, the program has been experiencing delays, including turbopump issues, combustion instability, overheating, and engine life that was less than expected. As a result, Blue Origin had problems keeping the engines working at full power for the required time. The corporation recently took the desperate choice of shipping the not-yet-assembled flight engines to their client, the ULA. Nevertheless, the delivery may now be delayed until early 2022 rather than the earlier announced dates. So far, Blue Origin's relationship with ULA has worsened, partly because of Blue Origin's attempt in 2017 to renegotiate for a higher price than agreed in 2014. The BE-4's delayed development has gotten more and more attention. This is because of the fact that the ULA has been working on its new Vulcan rocket for several years. The new rocket is critical to the company's future. The military is also looking forward to this delivery, as ULA, together with SpaceX, are the major providers of launch services to the Department of Defense. The military hopes that Vulcan will deliver launch services at a lesser cost using engines made in the United States. Finally, many people in the space community are generally interested in learning what's causing the delay. At the same time, the US military committed $255.5 million to the BE-4 development as part of the Launch Services Agreement, all paid by the taxpayers, so they have the right to know. But despite the high level of curiosity, Blue Origin has remained tight-lipped on its engine development. But throughout that period, what has SpaceX done? Although SpaceX mentioned the Raptor in 2009, the Raptor upper stage engine was merely a low priority. At the time, the new SpaceX rocket was to be unveiled in the next 1 to 3 years, according to the company's representatives. The large engine was to be used for the next generation of launch vehicles, which can launch payload masses of up to 150 to 200 tons into Earth's orbit, exceeding the NASA Space Launch System's payload mass capability. Later, in October 2013, SpaceX announced that the John C. Stennis Space Center in Hancock County, Mississippi, would be used to test Raptor engine components using liquid and hot methane. It also would be expanding the existing test stand infrastructure to accommodate the use of liquid and hot gas methane engine components. Stennis test stands restoration and maintenance were finished in April 2014 to prepare for Raptor component testing. The engine component testing program began in earnest with a focus on developing a robust starter and shutdown procedures, which were completed in May 2014. At long last, SpaceX started working on injectors in 2014 and tested a full-scale oxygen pre-burner at full power in 2015. The pre-burner was put through 76 fire tests from April to August 2015, totaling about 400 seconds of testing time. A series of planned tests at NASA facilities were completed by SpaceX in 2014 and 2015. Raptor engine testing at SpaceX's McGregor facilities in Central Texas began shortly in early 2016. SpaceX's Hawthorne plant in California manufactured the first Raptor rocket engine, which was shipped to McGregor's rocket engine test facility in Texas for development testing in August 2016. This engine was the first full-flow stage combustion Methalox engine ever tested. The engine passed a 9-second firing test without any malfunctions whatsoever. Until recently, SpaceX has broken ground on a second Raptor engine production facility. The California facility will focus on Raptor 2 serial manufacturing, while the Texas facility will focus on Raptor vacuum and new experimental Raptor designs. The new factory will ultimately be able to produce 800 to 1,000 rocket engines each year. Elon Musk has said the Raptor production is reaching 1 per 48 hours. Raptor is expected to fly 1,000 times in its lifespan, according to SpaceX. The engine's material costs were estimated to be nearing $1 million in 2019. Up to 500 Raptor engines will be mass-produced annually by SpaceX. Each one was less than $250,000. Oh yeah, we can't deny Blue Origin is way far behind. This proves that the BE-4 was not how it was supposed to be, and no matter how much it resembles SpaceX's Raptor, it will never be able to compete with the master of rocket engines. And that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. What are your thoughts on the Blue Origin's BE-4 engines? And will it ever come close to the SpaceX Raptor 1 or 2? Let us know in the comments. Also, if you are interested in more videos like this, please make sure you like and subscribe to this channel. Goodbye, SpaceX fans. See you in the next one.